Welcome back. We'll start with NCERT Political Science Class 8 Chapter 6 that talks about the criminal justice system in India. Now here we have a case study that was of Shanti and who is a kind of domestic servant in the family of Mr. and Mrs. Shinde. Now we have the two parties here and the judge here. We'll understand this case as it is. So these two persons are, on one side you have Shanti and on the other side you have Mr. Shinde, Mr. and Mrs. Shinde. Now this Shinde's family complained that Shanti stole a chain from their house. Now this Mr. Shinde went to their family and searched for the chain. However, they could not find the chain but could find 10,000 as a cash money in the house of Shanti. They complained, they went to the police station, fired an FIR, that's the first information report with the police station, saying that Shanti stole a chain from their house and in lieu of which they could find rupees 10,000 in her home. Now, since there was a case that was filed, you have Shinde's family and Shanti with her brother Sushil who was there. And both of them have been accused of stealing jewelry. Now, this is a kind of scenario that has been formed. This Shinde's family hires a lawyer. However, since Shanti is poor and cannot afford, you would have a lawyer that would be provided by the government. Now, under the constitution, it says any person has the right to hire a lawyer. If they are not able to hire themselves, the government would provide them the lawyer. So Shanti gets a lawyer. Now this lawyer tries to defend Shanti. Now what are the points in which they would defend? So some of the defense statements would be, did you saw Shanti stealing? Did you find the chain in her house? If she saves 1,000, if she earns 1,000 per month, she can definitely save 10,000. Now Shanti says that she want to save that 10,000 for her developments in the village, for buying a bullock or something. So this is again true. So since you have not found the gold chain, you have not seen her stealing, she has been working for the last 3 years and so far she has stolen nothing. So how can you say that this chain was stolen by her? Now this lawyer defends Shanti and you have the other lawyer who is defending Shinde, and both of them are presenting the case to the judge. Now judge, as you can see, is blind. That means he is impartial. He is not in favor of rich or poor. He is not favoring either of those and impartially decides the case. So that's the system how a kind of criminal justice system works. Now finally, the police person found that there was a gang of boys roaming around in the city and that gang stole the jewelry or the chain, and finally that chain was procured. So that's the kind of story that is being formed here and that is being explained to help you understand the criminal justice system. Now under the criminal justice system, there are four key players. You have the police person who is taking the case, who is reporting it as the first witness. You have the public prosecutor, who is a law officer appointed by the government, either the center or the state or the district level. Then you have the defense lawyer, who is defending the case, and finally the judge, who is innocent and impartial. As you can see, we do not have a judge with eyes here. That means the judge is impartial and he is unbiased. Now, let's frame another case here. You had a dam construction that was taking place in a nearby vicinity of your town, and one day that dam broke. What would happen will be the government would file the case against the officers who had been constructing the dam. Now the government would hire, or the law officer who would represent the government would be the public prosecutor. The person who would be defending those who constructed the dam would be the defense lawyer. Both of these would present the case to the judge, and it would be finally the judge who would decide what would be the final results. Now, what is the role of police? Now, police, as we said, is the witness, collects the evidence, registers the complaints, and police tries to form an opinion. If the police thinks that the evidence points to a guilt of an accused person, they can file a charge sheet. That charge sheet goes for investigations, and under the Supreme Court guidelines, the police explains the time of arrest, detention and interrogation, However, during investigation, police cannot do any kind of torture and cannot inflict any form of punishment. So, police has no right to give any form of punishment. It could only come from the judge finally. Under Article 22 of the Constitution, we talk about the criminal law guarantee, and it says the person who is being arrested must be informed. The person must be presented before the magistrate within 24 hours of the arrest. He cannot be ill-treated or tortured, and confessions made in the police custody cannot be used as evidence, because police can use means to ask him to reveal something which actually does not happen. Again, if there is a woman or a child below 15 years, they cannot be brought to police station only for the purpose of questioning. Now, there are three important articles that we usually talk about. Article 21 says protection of life and liberty. Article 20 talks about protection in respect of conviction for the offences, and Article 22 says protection against arrest and detention. So, all these three articles work for the liberty of an individual. And then you had the DK Basu's guideline that talks about the arrest, interrogation and detention for a criminal person. Now, what are the issues that have been talked about? First, a police officer, once carrying out the arrest, should take or wear clear identifiable identifications with name tags. So, he should have a name badge without which he cannot interrogate or arrest a person. A memo of arrest should be prepared during the time of arrest with the date and time, and it should be the person should be arrested by at least one of the witness, who could be even the family member of the person. Again, the person who is being arrested has the right to inform his friend, his relative or any well-wisher. And if the person whom he is informing is outside the district, they are allowed to be notified by the police within 8 to 12 hours of arrest. So, if a person is residing, say, in Mumbai and one of his relative is in Thane or let's say in Wardha, so they would be given 8 to 12 hours to be notifying that information to the friend or the relative he wants to. Then the police files the FIR, that's the first information report, and under this you have the investigation of the crime that begins, and the officer in charge takes down the FIR. If they feel the case is consignable, that means for which the police can arrest without the permission from the court, it should include the name, address, time, basic facts and the dates, and the complaint, who is writing the complaint, would be given a copy of the FIR. Now, what's the role of the public prosecutor? As we said, he is a law officer who is being appointed by the government. So, he works in the interest of the state. He begins his work after the police interrogation is being done and the charge sheet has been filed. Again, he is brought to the court, and as we said, the court is impartial. So, judge is a kind of umpire for the game. He conducts it with impartiality and unbiasedness. He hears to all the witnesses on both the sides and then gives a final judgment. Based on the judgment, the sentence is given. It could be the person could either be fined or be jailed, or there could be both things that could happen. Now, what is a fair trial? That is very, very important. Article 21 guarantees the right to life, and under right to life, we talk about liberty from any kind of legal procedures, and that includes a fair trial. That means the trial would be taken out in an open court. There would be presence of the accused. He can cross-examine the witness. The matter would be decided based on the evidences only and not on the evidences given in the police room, and there would be no partiality, or it would be totally unbiased. So, these are the key things of the fair trial basis. So, as we saw, there are four key role players in the system of public prosecution. You have the police, the public prosecutor, defense lawyer and judge, and we understood how the criminal system works. What's the role of the police? What's the role of a public prosecutor and a judge? With this, we cover class 6, chapter 6 of class 8 NCERT Political Science. We'll be covering further lectures in the upcoming classes. So, stay tuned. Have a good day ahead.